Next topic is ketone. So how to prepare ketone? Already we know very well, primary aldehyde undergoes oxidation reaction, aldehyde is a product. Secondary aldehyde undergoes oxidation reaction, ketone is a product. So very same thing we are going to use here, secondary alcohol, namely isopropyl alcohol, CH3CH3CHOH. This is one of the secondary alcohol, namely isopropyl alcohol undergoes oxidation reaction in the presence of acidified potassium permanganate K2CR2O7. Now that is a removal of hydrogen H and O, removal of water. What is remaining? Acetone, CH3 CH3 C double bond O, namely acetone. So secondary alcohol undergoes oxidation reaction. Oxidation reaction takes place in the presence of acidified potassium dichromate. You'll get acetone as a product. Very same thing, calcium acetate undergoes a dry distillation reaction. Calcium acetate means CH3COOCa undergoes a dry distillation. Now calcium carbonate remaining is acetone. So acetone is CH3CH3CO plus calcium carbonate is the product. In that way also we can prepare acetone. Then secondary, that means isopropyl alcohol react with copper at 573 Kelvin. Isopropyl alcohol mean CH3 twice times CHOH reacts with copper at 573 Kelvin. Now removal of these two hydrogen atom, remaining is acetone, CH3 CH3 C double bond O. So first one is oxidation reaction takes place in the presence of acidified potassium dichromate. Second one is a dry distillation reaction takes place. Third one is oxidation reaction takes place in the presence of copper at 573 Kelvin. Now after that, hydrolysis of isopropylidene chloride. Isopropylidene chloride mean one carbon, two methyl group, CH3 CH3 ClCl, isopropylidene chloride. Now isopropylidene chloride reacts with two molecule of NaOH. Penna ho inge or NaOH, inge or NaOH. So removal of NaCl, enna aayiranga OH vandrum, CH3 CH3 OH OH, followed by removal of water, OH oru OH, removal of water, remaining is acetone, CH3 CH3 C double bond O, namely acetone. Acetone is the product. These are the possible ways to prepare ketones. Next, chemical properties of ketones. First one is ketone undergoes oxidation reaction. Ketone like acetone, CH3COCH3 undergoes oxidation reaction. We know very well, primary alcohol undergoes oxidation reaction, aldehyde is a product. Aldehyde further undergoes oxidation reaction, carboxylic acid is a product. Secondary alcohol undergoes oxidation reaction, acetone, ketone is a product. Ketone further undergoes oxidation reaction, carboxylic acid, but one carbon less than the ketone. So ketone la moonu carbon irukke, ketone undergoes oxidation reaction, carboxylic acid dhaan product a irukum, ana moonu carbon irukke, oru carbon less a ulla carboxylic acid, namely acetic acid, so that CH3COOH is the product, namely acetic acid. This is called propanone or acetone. So acetone undergoes oxidation reaction, acetic acid is the product. Very same thing, acetone undergoes reduction reaction, acetone, that means what? CH3 CO(CH3) undergoes reduction reaction with lithium aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride. They are going to add two hydrogen atoms here. One is nearby H, one is nearby carbon, one is nearby oxygen. So it will become a CH3, CH, OH, CH3, namely isopropyl alcohol. Isopropyl alcohol is one of the secondary alcohol. The secondary alcohol undergoes oxidation reaction, ketone is a product. Ketone undergoes reduction reaction, it gives secondary alcohol, just ultra reaction, opposite reaction. Secondary alcohol undergoes oxidation reaction, ketone is a product. Ketone undergoes reduction reaction, it gives secondary alcohol as a product. So reduction reaction takes place, anyone reducing agent like lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride, anyone reducing agent you can use. Then next one is Clemmensen reduction and Wolff-Kissel reduction, already we discussed one. Clemmensen reduction means aldehydes or ketones are converted to hydrocarbon in the presence of zinc amalgam and carbon HCl. Wolff-Kissel reduction, aldehydes or ketones are converted to hydrocarbon in the presence of hydrazine and sodium ethoxide. This is alone difference. Clemmensen reaction mean, or Clemmensen reaction mean aldehyde to hydrocarbon, the presence of zinc amalgam and carbon HCl, that only main thing. Very same thing for Wolff-Kissel reduction reaction, hydrazine and sodium ethoxide is a difference. Clemmensen mean zinc amalgam carbon HCl is a catalyst. Wolff-Kissel mean hydrazine and sodium ethoxide. Very same thing. Next one is halo form reaction. Halo form reaction. Acetone reacts with the chlorine. Acetone. Now three hydrogen atoms are replaced by three chlorine atoms, so that CCl3CO(CH3), namely trichloroacetone. Acetone reacts with chlorine molecule, it gives what? Trichloroacetone is a product. Trichloroacetone. Very same thing. Acetone reacts with ammonia. What's the product? It gives two molecules of acetone going to involve. First, acetone with ammonia. Acetone means CH3, CO, CH3, one of the acetone. Another acetone reacts with ammonia. Ammonia means NH2 and H. And one more acetone, namely you can write like this, CH3, CO, CH3. Two molecules of acetone and one molecule of ammonia. Now removal of water. Removal of water. So what is remaining? CH3, C single bond CH3. Two bond is there. One la amine, inna one la CH2CO CH3. CH2CO CH3. The kind of names are diacetone amine. Di enna sonna amine. Rendu acetone irukku. So that diacetone amine is the product. Idhe idhe. In the acetone reacts with chloroform. Acetone என்னது CH3 C double bond O CH3, this is acetone. Acetone reacts with chloroform CHCl3 தான் chloroform. Now reaction takes place in the presence of potassium hydroxide. Acetone reacts with chloroform. The reaction takes place in the presence of base. The presence of base என்ன கிடைக்கும்? குளோரிட்டோன் கிடைக்கும். பார்க்கலாமே CH3 C, மேல CH3 OH என்னாயிரும், OH ஆயிரும், இங்க CCl தாயிரும். இது பேரு குளோரிட்டோன். என்ன பேரு? Chloritone. So how to prepare chloritone? Anna solvinga ketone reacts with chloroform in the process of alkali like potassium hydroxide, you get chloritone as a product. Okay, after that, how to prepare mesityl oxide? These are the chemical properties of ketone. How to prepare mesityl oxide? Acetone. Acetone means CH3CO acetone. Acetone reacts with another acetone like this. I won't write CH3 CO CH3 is acetone. Now two molecules of acetone, dry HCl. Now removal of water molecule, removal of water molecule, what is the remaining? CH3 CH3 C double bond CH CO CH3, namely mesityl oxide. So CH3 CH3 C double bond CH CO CH3, namely mesityl oxide, nothing but 4-methyl-pent-3-ene-2-one mesityl oxide. If on the mesityl oxide la, I am going to add one more acetone. Mesityl oxide mean what? CH3 CH3 bond C double bond CH single bond CO CH3 la, I am going to add one more acetone like this, CH3 CH3 C double bond O. Okay, now here also removal of one water molecule, H2O. So remaining is CH double bond C, remaining acid is that named as CH3 CH3 C double bond CH single bond CO single bond CH. Double bond C 2-methyl group. So mesityl oxide reacts with one more acetone. It gives a boron as the product. It's named as what? Boron. BHORONE. Okay. Boron is the product. So acetone reacts with one more acetone. It gives in the presence of tri HCl, it gives mesityl oxide. Followed by mesityl oxide reacts with acetone, it gives the boron as the product. Last one is very important one, how to prepare mesityline. How to prepare mesityline? Acetone reacts with consulfuric acid. I want to take 3 molecules of acetone, CH3 CO CH3. Reaction takes place in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. 3 molecules of acetone, reaction takes place concentrated sulfuric acid. You get a mesityline is the product. Mesityline mean here is first all 3 hydrogen atoms. Here is methyl, here is methyl, here also methyl group. CH3 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 plus 3 molecules of water molecule. This is named as mesityline. What? So this is also very important for problem. So 3 molecules of acetone reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid. Reaction takes place, is a cyclic product, namely mesityline is the product. Okay, now ketones over. Next class we'll discuss about comparison of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, thank you students.